Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to The Witcher 3 on the That Much difficulty. We're still playing the Hearts of Stone DLC, and we're gonna hopefully complete the Open Sesame quest today. The Borsodi Heist will start in a minute. We're at the Herbalist House again, the Herbalist Hut. We're gonna head into the secret basement down below, where our crew should be waiting for us to start this off. So the lovely Evelyn and what's the other guy's name again? Quentin?
And Countess Yvonne of Lanexeter's necklace. Your handiwork, wasn't it?
It was. I scaled a gutter, entered her bedchamber.
Ha! I knew it, I knew it.
Ah! Hello, guys!
Time to begin.
This is gonna be awesome. Suggest.
So if any of you has any doubts, isn't sure, now's the time to leave. Won't be able to after. The Borsodi's auction house, its vault. That's our target. Everline, you'll enter through the tower when the patrol rounds this corner. Drop us a line. We have to be inside within 5 minutes, is that enough?
It's plenty.
Splendid. Once we're all in the tower, we'll proceed to the auction house. Shouldn't see any guards inside. If we do, we'll have Geralt and his blades. Then, downstairs to the vault.
Quinto, that was it.
Crack the lock. We get in the vault, take the loot, disappear out the back through a secret passage. I've said my piece. Any questions?
Wait, there's a secret passage? Why not get in that way? Yeah, that was exactly my idea. My thought.
Got a horse sense take on this. Secret passage. If we plan to use it on the way out, why not on the way in?
Excellent question. Why not?
Every corridor has two ends, right? Like a rope. I know the location of just one end. It's in the vault. The other, it's somewhere beneath the city. But I can't tell you where.
Okay, fair enough.
Great.
Find that location. I wouldn't need any of you. Believe you me, I've tried. Time and again. Anything else?
Sounds about right. No plan B if something goes seriously wrong. Any security measures inside?
Additional security measures. Traps. Any inside? Anything we need to watch out for?
Nothing particularly dangerous. Here on the ground floor, there's a rope linked to the bell in the tower. Anyone sounds the alarm, there'll be trouble.
How do you stop it from ringing?
Don't pull the rope. As I said, the auction house ought to be empty. I don't expect any problems.
Can we cut the rope?
How is it secured?
With a door. But you ought to be able to handle it. Any other problems, we resolve as they come. Anything else?
And a plan B? No plan B?
All good and fine, except... what if something goes wrong? Seriously.
You're on your own. We all are.
Oh, you're just a friendly like fellow.
No room for friendship in this business.
Okay, let's get to work then.
All right, let's get to work. Want to be done with this as soon as possible.
We'll reconvene in the gateway beside the tower. Midnight sharp. And everyone's to make sure they're not followed. I'll get word to the cook in the barracks.
What about wearing masks? Not a city in the north that don't have wanted posters with my likeness hanging about.
I'll tend to that. Ah, one last thing.
Inform okay.
The city watch. Blabber anything about this over a nail, and I'll kill you with my own hands.
Ooh, should we be afraid? I don't think we are afraid. I say we go together now. Well, sounds like a plan.
If you're so damn scared somebody will talk, let's all go there together. Now.
Any objections? Anyone need more time?
I don't think they do.
Then.
Great! Well, great for me, that is, because I don't need to edit all that out. Look at Geralt's outfit!
Prime. Just one patrol.
Look at his black outfit, that's cool.
Eveline, you ready?
Are you kidding?
She looks ready.
Of course I am.
And Quinto, he is silent as always. Although he's not really silent, is he? He had a big mouth before. Why not now?
Three.
Hello.
Two.
Nameless man.
One.
Okay. There goes the patrol.
It's clear. On your way.
Wow, okay. Look at her go. Oh.
Plowing city foul. shite all over again.
Look at that. Whack. That was awesome. Let's all get on the rope.
We've 1 minute. Move.
60, 59, 58. Well, you get to rest. I think they have plenty of time. Oh, just climb up the rope, dammit. Three guys on a single rope. Hurry up. You can only pull up the rope if everybody's up there, so No. Okay. There we go. Okay. Now maybe pull in the rope. Great. Pigeon shat on your helmet. We are looking out for each other, it seems. So let's see what we can find inside.
There be no one inside.
Seems my informer was wrong.
Is that all you've got to say? I nearly broke my neck.
You knew what you were signing up for. This is no time to argue.
She handled it gracefully, though. Agreed. Past the point of no return, we'll argue later, you can be sure of that.
Gotta agree. Backing out's not an option anymore. Need to see this through, whatever happens.
Hallowed words. One guard could mean many more. You'd best draw your sword now.
No.
Where are my swords, by the way?
No one dies. Said so from the start.
We're gonna be sneaky. Oh. Wooden swords. Great. Not so great. Thank you, Eveline. I want to call her Evelyn, but yeah, it's probably Eveline the way it's written.
Whatever. Don your masks and let's go.
Those look freaky, especially on her. Is that a king's face? That's supposed to be Radovid's face? Creepy. Ooh. I can start looting already. Let's check this out a bit.
Letters must be old. String seems to say so too.
Love letter. Annotation. Item acquired with the rest of the Von Everack estate. Put up for auction. Starting price 1 crown. No bids. My love, don't give up. There's still a week till you're off to wed your fury. I'll think of something. Perhaps I'll get the coin by then. Perhaps my tears will convince your father. Perhaps the gods will hear our prayers. Or if not they, perhaps some devil will. If nothing else helps, I'll crash into the temple through the window and swoop you up from the altar. We'll flee somewhere, far, far away, to the edge of the world, where no one will find us. You're right of sadness, I feel its weight too. I think of you constantly, of how we sat at the alchemy till dawn, nursing a bottle of wine, and you traced our dream house in the sawdust on the floor. Of how we dangled our feet in the water from the dock and you sang those bawdy songs and made me laugh and laugh. I kiss the medallion carrying your portrait before I fall asleep, and as soon as I wake, I swear on all that is holy, we shall be together forever. Be brave. I love you. Your O. And of course we know, that's all geared. And the woman he loved, which caused him to... turned that Ofuri prince into a toad. That was the Ofuri he was talking about. Interesting. A love letter from Olgierd. So let's see. Let's go down. Don't think there's anything else here. And let's see if there are any guards here. I'm going to suppose there are.
Clear for now. Knock on wood.
Good. Eyes in the back of your heads, everyone.
Mine are open. I've already seen several things I'd gladly take with me.
The vault. That's our target. Is that clear?
Is the vault down below?
Yes, but we shall raise the starting point. Watch this! Guards! Guards!
Uh-oh. Hello, Hilbert.
Stayed in that cage.
You said...
I damn well know what I said. At them before they sound the alarm.
Oh, God. Oh, wow. Why are they not damaging me, by the way? Not that I'm damaging them really, but... Oh god. I'm just whacking right now, because well, yeah, I'm just whacking. Because we're doing minimal damage, so I'm trying to whack the shit out of everybody here. Oh, gold. Hello, Borsodi. That was a real sword.
Stop him! He's not to flee!
Oh, gold. Do we need to... Look at that. This is fucking awesome shit. Ooh, that's an issue. That's a big issue. And he's killing people, left and right.
Lock themselves in.
Bollocks!
Damn it.
Lay down your arms! You have no chance!
Perhaps not.
Ooh, this is getting dark.
But we do have hostages.
Mercy, master!
On the count of three, we go in. One, two!
Come one step closer and folk will die.
I think folk have already died.
What are your demands? To release the hostages?
Buy us a bit of time, Geralt.
Not about to use innocents as living shields. Well, I don't think we have much... choice.
We have one demand. Pull back from the auction house.
You know I cannot do that.
You can, just not sure you want to. How about I help you decide? Kill a hostage.
Just do what they want. I beg you.
Calm yourself. No one is to be harmed. Clear?
Nothing simpler. So long as you take your boys and pull out. We'll all live happily ever after.
I repeat, that is not an option. We must bargain, reach an agreement.
Okay. Bring us a wagon and horses. Maybe that's something to start with.
So we want a wagon and horses.
It's the middle of the night. Where am I to find a wagon?
Rather than looking for caskets.
He means it!
Good point. A wagon then? What kind?
Time you took a gander downstairs.
Oh, well done, Quinto. Carriage right over to his coronation. Long as it rolls.
We're not picky. Any old cart, long as it has wheels that roll.
All right, I'll get it done. In exchange, you must release the hostages.
How many?
All of them.
I'll set one free now, the rest later.
You know I can't do that. Here's a compromise. One hostage now, the rest once the wagon arrives.
That should gain us a bit of trust.
So be it. Agreed.
Thanks be to Melitele.
But anything smells fishy, or you dawdle even a bit, heads will roll, understand?
Calm now.
That's a very thin window, by the way.
A quarter hour's out. Matko, Shadru. City stables, on the double.
Let's go check out the vault.
Good work.
Sorry, boys. You'll have to go on without me. I didn't sign on for this turn of events.
Just one way out of here. Through the vault.
Yeah, you're gonna have to join us anyway, so...
There's a second. The chimney. Believe I'll squeeze through.
Doubt you can, Witcher. You've no choice, I'm afraid. Let's go. Downstairs.
Thanks for the help, Evelyn. Eveline? That's weird with that moustache and all. So let's go down into the vault. Let's hurry a bit. There we go. Down we go. Evelyn Gallo character entry updated. And wow, this place is pretty big. Maybe I should take a look around. Quick look around. A little gander. No, nothing I can check out. Okay, never mind. Never mind, I'm following the stranger. Wondering who that stranger actually is. Maybe it's gone through Dim. List of objects in need of restoration. Preparation for the upcoming auction. I hereby certify the receipt of the following items entrusted to me for restoration. Elven porphyritic statue of Aelirin, sculpted by an unknown master. A lady draped with hung fox, oil painting from the atelier of Master Vandernope. Jadeite statuette of a goose girl and seven accompanying geese figurines. Pipe carved of a cherry wood with a ceramic stem, certified to have belonged to Nina Fioravanti. Pinewood trunk ornamented with brass elements, crafted by the workshop of Samson of Ban Ard. A painting by Van Rogue, the pseudonym associated with the work of Lady Iris von Everack. Van Rogue is a pseudonym associated with the work of Lady Iris von Everack. That's interesting. Hans from Megaren. That was a name that was in that letter. Let's see. Anything else of interest? On the bookshelves, nothing in red. Wait. There's something here. Request for payment. This document certifies that my principal, Emmett Lumen Dorf and Sons, Incorporated, registered in Tretagor, has authorized my office to make payment for services rendered, namely the forging and installation of Dadley, doubly fortified and armored doors fitted with Colossus brand locks for the vault of the Borsodi Brothers Auction House in Oxenford. This document likewise constitutes a request for payment in the amount of 65,000 Novigrad crowns within 2 weeks of its receipt. If at the conclusion of said period no payment has been made, collection procedures will be initiated in the proper judicial channels. Robert Hilbert, Esquire. Wait, is that the same Hilbert from upstairs? So he's the guy that allowed them to install this vault? That's weird. There's another one here. Letter from Master Matthew. Because there were three guys talking to each other, and one of them was Hilbert. Dear Master Borsodi, I write to you concerning a most atypical matter. But please do not dismiss it summarily, for both you and the institution you run are in great danger. Allow me to explain what I mean. It so happens I am a renowned astrologist and teller of fortunes. In recent days, for evident reasons, I have been forced into hiding, but a small circle of loyal customers has been kept informed of my whereabouts. One of these customers is a lady of high birth. Her name I shall not disclose out of discretion. Said lady came to me with a request. She wanted to learn what price would be certain items would sell for at an upcoming auction. After voicing my many objections, I nevertheless relented to the lady's request. But before you take offense at this interference in your business, please read to the end, for the cards I laid out for this lady told me something very important. The constellation of the cards clearly indicated the wolf shall appear at your doorstep, and you shall not let him enter, but he shall nevertheless find a way inside. He shall enter your house, then take your house from you. I saw a tower struck by lightning and blood drinking blood. I believe you are extremely aware what that signifies, am I not right? As fair reward for this warning, please hand a sum of 2,000 crowns to the man delivering this message. My sincerest respects, Master Matthew. So his prediction is pretty spot on. A wolf shall appear at your doorstep and you shall not let him enter, but he will find a way inside. We did. And he will take your house from you. That's probably the house we need to find. And then I saw a tower struck by lightning and blood drinking blood. Interesting. So that probably hints at what is to come, I suppose. Let's see. I think there's no more letters here. This looks like the vault. Hello, Quinto. Open up this big door, will you?
The lock. Lovingly crafted. Two spring-loaded bolts, cylindrical plugs, dimeritian wards.
I'm not interested. No one's interested. We go in. Geralt, you're at the fore.
Why me?
It's why I hired you. Now move. We've no time.
You didn't really hire us, but hey. Here we go then. Mm-hmm.
Do or die.
Indeed, do or die. Let's open it up. Oh god, what traps are gonna be in here? I have my swords back for some reason. Oh yeah, there we go. There we go.
Shit. As if I haven't seen enough excitement.
I need insectoid oil. I can't roll away from these things. This is annoying. Oh god. So that's one. Get over here, fucking goddammit, fucking idiotic creatures, get down. Let's put it out of its misery. Okay, goddammit, that was fucking annoying. That was ridiculous. So 4 arachnomorphs almost got me killed. Hopefully that's the end of the excitement. Let's take a look around here, because there seem to be... Ooh, I'm gonna take everything. Every little thing there is.
Same paintings were on the block.
Yes, indeed they were. So we need to find Borsodi's house. Whatever that means, by the way. Because we don't really know how that looks like. It seems awfully quiet here. Stranger? Okay, do I need to just move on? Okay, apparently we do. Because this is a bigger room inside that other room. Okay, they're already inside. How the hell did that work?
On the contrary, I know all too well.
Are they brothers?
Yeah. Yule?
Yeah, they're brothers.
Greetings, brother.
Because it was the Borsodi's brothers' auction house.
Oh, well, complications.
Hmm. You owe us an explanation, Ewald Borsodi.
Think you owe us an explanation, Ewald Borsodi. This family reunion, what's the point?
Revenge. For betrayal. Years of poverty. Humiliation.
So that's the blood, drinking blood.
To me, in his will. Horst cheated me. Had me disinherited.
Anything. Everything we earned, you squandered on cards and whores. Father didn't see that. I did.
That's no excuse, Horst. Save your life.
You two, stand with me. I'll not let the Redanians lay a hand on you, give you whatever you want.
Huh. This is, interesting. Tempting offer, Horst. I'm not really bought, right? Now we have been getting our asses kicked because of the guards that, Borsodi Horst, sent after us, so I'll stick to Ewald.
A desperate attempt at bribery going once, twice, thrice. No takers, no sale.
Speak for yourself. Tempting offer. I've succumbed.
Oh. Goodbye, Quinto.
You'll pay for that, Quinto. With your head. At them!
I wonder if Quinto just goes with the other party either way. So let's switch to Hangman's Venom. There we go, Hangman's Venom. Let's see if we can't use Axie on one of them. So Quinto is down. Oh! I think Horst just died. Oh, okay, probably low enough health to get us down to that. Goodbye, Horst. So, is this gonna end in a brother murder?
I'd prefer to resolve this elsewise. Stolen the scrolls, thrown you out into the street. Revenge is best served cold, after all.
But you could still do that.
No. I beg you, mercy for your brother. I shall do anything you ask.
Truly.
Anything.
Anything!
Sign over to me. All that you own. Then walk out as you stand, with just the clothing on your back.
Allow me one thing. Any one thing.
Did he just kill him, or was that just his hand?
In the sewers. Like a beast, and you've the cheek to plead.
He's gonna smack that over your head. Yeah, there we go. You want your revenge served cold? Oh, wow. His face is gone. Yeah, there we go. It's in his mouth somewhere. That got gruesome all of a sudden. Yeah. That was the bite me sign. Oh yeah, show us that, please. Holy shit. That
satisfied.
Was rough.
Exceptionally. You?
No, and I won't be until I find Max Borsodi's house. In this vault, or so you said.
And it is. There. But I fear it's not yours for the taking.
It is.
You see, it houses my father's will. A scroll, thanks to which Ewald Borsodi, long missing, will assume the family fortune.
And Geralt of Rivia, who you cheated, what'll he assume?
Alas, but he's free to choose anything else.
Don't provoke me. No, we kinda need that.
No, might choose to take your head.
You're wounded. Tired. Figure my chances are good.
I don't think you, know who you're dealing with. This is not a bust, we can figure this out.
I could drop you easily, but maybe I don't have to. We could try to figure this out.
A compromise looks unlikely. We both want Max's house.
Not quite. You just need the contents. Me, the box.
The downstairs!
So be it. Seal it with a handshake.
Give me the damn casket, and let's get out of here.
Yes, indeed. He might stab us in the face if he does that. With one of these treasures lying around here. Shoving it up my throat. Is it heavy? Because it looks heavy. Maximilian Borsodi's house. And he stuffed that in his pocket somewhere. Again. This guy has a nice fucking place, though. Ooh, Fury crossbow. Interesting. Anything else I can check here? I'm gonna raid this entire place if I can. Vial! Yes, I needed a vial. That was everything I ever wished for. Not, but hey. Ooh, Viper Venomous Steel Sword. Ooh. There's diagrams in this place. Let's see what else is here then. Silver platter, gold diamond ring, gold diamond ring. He doesn't look pissed that I'm stealing everything because it's technically his now. Oh yeah, so Horse probably used this tunnel to get inside the vault quicker. And he knew about this tunnel because, well, the vault once was accessible to Ewald here, because he was Horst's brother. And he probably lived here for a while as well. So let's see. We need to get out of here, probably not too far away since Horst got here so easily. More stuff. Lead the way, I would say. Do I need to pull this? Okay, I'll pull it. Ooh, we're inside another house. And it seems we're out. The heist completed and, well, Quinto's dead. Horst is dead, died gruesomely. At least Ewald is still alive.
Well, here's where our paths part.
Shut up.
Was I that bad?
No, but you came awfully close, Ewald. Survived by a hair.
Yeah, because we could have killed you easily.
You ever have a basilisk hide or fiend horns and want a good price? Look for me at the auction house.
Why are we yelling?
Consider it noted.
Sounds like a good plan, though. So now we can sell stuff at a pretty nice penny. And Ewald, probably. Take Maximilian Borsodi's house to Allgeared, and since we're still in Oxenfurt, we'll head towards the inn here. And talk to Allgeared immediately. I hope that doesn't take too long, because otherwise this is going to be a pretty long episode. But hey, we'll deal with that when it comes. So let's see. Entree. And he should be still at the same place, probably. And the wild ones are still here as well. Hello, Allgeared.
Need to chat.
And now he probably wants to know where the contents of the house are. Got Borsodi's house for you.
Got something for you.
I love gifts, but I prefer to unwrap them in private.
Right, okay.
Lads, mind the barrels. Going out for a jabber with Geralt. Come.
And that only leaves one more wish. The last wish, if you will.
Oh, that's better. All right.
Some people will get that. We have the house.
That's Borsodi's house, as requested.
Clunk! It was in my pocket all along. It's empty though. Look. He's looking at all angles.
Left them in the vault. You wanted the house, you got the house. Never mentioned its contents.
Hehehehe. Quick study. Already as tricky as Odin himself. Keen to ridicule a man. Do you know what I and the company do with your type?
I'd like to see you try. Ask for legal advice.
Dunno. Ask for legal advice? Looks to me like you might need some. You signed the contract, Allgeared. I'm just fulfilling its terms, to the letter. Unhappy? Hell, should have chosen your words more carefully.
Yeah, you should have been,
Yes.
Prepare for that by now.
I assume you came to an agreement with Horst. Shame. A right horse in that one.
Well, he's dead.
Made a deal with his brother, who then beat the living shit out of Horst with a gold candle holder.
And literally...
It's progress.
The living shit is out. Horst is dead. Did you know Horst had a brother?
Horst's brother.
Probably.
Did you know about
it? It was called the Borsodi brothers.
I think so. Ewald was famous in certain circles.
Which ones?
We still have Olgierd's love letter as well.
Don't usually associate with. He murdered for coin, no questions, without batting an eye. Always extravagantly, though. If not for his damn surname, I believe I'd have invited him to join the company.
What was his surname, then?
Why did you even need those
Can't
papers?
Ask that, sadly.
To sing the Borsodis, naturally. You see, I learned of an interesting clause in old man Maximilian's will. It states that his sons must meet and shake hands in agreement at least once a year at Bellatane. Failing that, the auction house must be auctioned off. The proceeds to go to Vilmeria's hospital.
Guess the old man sensed what might happen.
Aim to deliver those papers to the right hands. Borsodi would have landed in the streets. And the hospital would have gotten the funds it needs to treat orphans and beggars pro bono.
Awfully noble of you, showing so much concern for the needy.
I couldn't give a rat's arse about the needy. May they wither and disappear along with the city. I wanted one thing. Revenge.
Looks like everybody wants revenge these days. So, what's your gripe exactly with the Borsodis? Why do you want revenge?
What's your gripe? Get kicked out of an auction?
Worse. They evicted me from my home. Are you really interested?
So that's why we found a lot of items belonging to the Von Everick estate.
Wouldn't have asked if I wasn't.
Ha! Cheeky as ever.
Of course we are.
My family. They took on some debt. A poor investment in a sawmill. A bad crop one year. A lawsuit lost. You know how it is. When it rains, it pours. We needed but a few weeks to recover. But Horst Borsodi had acquired our debt. All of it. Demanded it be repaid immediately. I pleaded. I begged. I tore open my shirt at his threshold. Ugh, it was like talking to a wall. I went to the auction. Saw those perfumed pricks by my father's sword. My mother's death mask. My brother's horse tack. Ah, Horst earned a pretty pile selling our mementos.
No surprise the animosity you feel for him.
That was but the start. My Iris's parents learned of my family's misfortune. And our betrothal was not...
Oh, so that was another reason...
They found her another suitor. One from beyond the sea. The anger I felt. I thought I'd gone mad. Went to the tavern. Drank a round. A second. Abroad. Then had another tankard. And then... I asked the wrong bloke for help.
What happened then?
What happened then?
Because watch out, old Geert, I'm getting sympathy for you.
And then, Witcher, was one big stinking pile of shite.
Okay, go on, old Geert, I want to know.
Why do you stand there? Do you need something still?
Yeah, we kind of have a love letter you might want back. Maybe? Maybe not. Open sesame complete. So let's see what your last wish is. Third task. Tell me about it. Nice saber. Interesting. The company you keep. Never mind. I can't even ask him about the love letter. Seriously? That's too bad. Third task. Tell me about it.
Third wish. Time you stated it.
A moment, Geralt. I must say to something. Then we'll chat. You there. Yank the herring out the barrel.
Okay. They were kicking that barrel constantly. Is there someone in there? Who's in the barrel? Hi?
Come on! None of this dallying!
Do we need to know who you are? You don't look familiar.
Now, ready to listen? Or do you still not give two shites about what I've got to say?
I'm ready. I'm listening.
Good. You'll return to your lord and tell him as follows. His demand was brazen. Hurt me to the core. For I was brought up to respect the sacred law of hospitality. And I shall not bend to an uncouth boor's dictum. Understood. I will pay him a visit shortly to test his willingness to adapt. So you ride off and announce me. And don't spare your horse. Got it?
Got it.
That sounds interesting.
Give this man a mount and leave him go. Come, Witcher. We must talk outside.
Apparently we must.
The Aethiri believe one should only discuss important matters out of doors, with the gods as witnesses.
Okay. So, why were you keeping that man in a barrel? Yeah, that's a pretty apt question.
On the way here, we stopped for nourishment at a tavern belonging to one Lord Dauntless. We enjoyed ourselves as one does at an inn. Raucously. Our antics were not to the liking of this Dauntless. Sent a man to warn us that if we were ever to return, we would hang.
You burned the inn down?
I left ample compensation with the innkeep. But it seems the rapscallion neglected to mention this to his lord. But that's of little import. What matters is someone called me a whoreson and threatened to kill me. It was one of those threats.
And now Olgierd is mad.
I intend to accept it. Return to those parts.
And, you'll get what's coming to you one day. Maybe not antagonize him a bit. So, third task. Here we go.
Fulfilled two of your wishes. I learned the third.
It's not going to be an easy one, I suppose.
Proud, sure of your strengths. Fearless.
Third task, if you don't mind.
Mutations. They stripped you of emotion. Tell me, have you ever loved? I mean, truly loved?
Of course we have. Your third wish now. Yes, I've loved. I never loved. You don't give a shit. Does he give a shit?
You don't give a shit, Olgierd.
You make piss-poor company for a talk about love anyway.
Yeah, there we go.
Still waiting to hear it.
Aye, aren't you stubborn? Fine. Listen well. I had a wife once. The day I saw her last, I gave her a rose. A violet one.
A rose of remembrance?
Bring me that blue. Wouldn't mind reminding myself what it looks like.
When was that? How long's it been? Flowers wilted and turned to dust by now.
You wished to hear a wish. Now you have. Fulfill it. I ride now to visit this dauntless, but one of my men will remain here. He'll know how to find me. That is, of course, should you succeed.
At least you could tell me where your wife is.
In my old manor.
Dead?
East of Martin Foy's farmstead. I'd wish you godspeed, but, well, you understand, I'm sure.
Yeah, of course, because...
Goodbye, Geralt.
So as we expected, the last wish is pretty much undoable, probably, unless that rose somehow made it out of that. Scenes from a marriage. We need to go to the Von Everick Manor next and try to talk to Iris, his wife. And she apparently is still alive. But we're going to take a little break, so we're going to do that in the next episode. Thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So, without further ado, goodbye, and I'll see you next time.